Teruan Saranai. Welcome to another episode of Kirana TV Daham Kirana. This poede, we are going to talking about why do we learn about Buddhism. We have invited to Most Venerable Kalugamuya Kassapa Thero to conduct this program. Why do we learn Buddhism? Religion plays a big role in everyone's life. We as Buddhists should learn our religion, Buddhism. Buddhism is more than a religion. It is a way of life. It teaches us how to lead our lives in the right way from the very young age. It teaches us many things, manners, ethics, and also skills. Learning Buddhism is a fun because it has a very large and very rich literature as well. It is full of stories and many interesting characters. When it comes to living in abroad, learning Buddhism helps a great deal in shaping our lives.
Dear children, today I am going to be talking about Buddhism. We all are Buddhists. You all are Buddhists. We are learning Buddhism. We are following Buddhism. So today, let us see the importance of learning and following Buddhism as a religion. Buddhism as a religion has a very long history. As you all know, it goes back to 2600 years. It was originated, it was started in India, as we all know. You have learned the story of the Buddhism. The Buddha, Prince Siddhartha, in India 2600 years ago, he discovered this religion or this teaching called Buddhism. Nowadays we call it Buddhism, nowadays we call it a religion, but it is more than a religion. We call it a way of life. Buddhism is not something that we believe in. Buddhism is something that we do, that we should follow, that we should practice. So Buddhism is a practical religion, you can call it, and you can call it a way of life, something that we should practice. There are many practical teachings in Buddhism. As little kids, we learn how to behave well, how to respect our elders, how to respect our teachers, and to observe precepts. So those are the basic things as little children we learn from Buddhism. So let us see why we follow Buddhism as a religion and what are the things we should learn and what are the things we will be getting by following Buddhism as a religion. As I said, it is a very long, very old religion. It has a very long history, 2600 years old. And this religion teaches us many things. It teaches us how to behave, how to respect our elders, and how to lead our lives well, in the righteous way, in the correct way. And we know in the world today, there are many faiths, many religions. People follow different faiths, different religions. There are a large number of people who do not follow a religion. We call them secular people. They introduce themselves as secular people. They do not follow a religion as such. But there are many people who follow these other faiths, be it Buddhism, be it Christianity, or Islam, Hinduism, whatever it is. So by following a religion, what do we expect? We expect to be good people, to be good citizens. So that is what we expect by following a religion. So let us see what are the ethics that we learn from our religion, from our Buddhism. One basic thing that we all practice as Buddhists is to observe precepts. You observe 5 precepts, you observe 8 precepts, sometimes you observe 10 precepts. So we call them precepts. These precepts teach us how to behave, how to discipline. Let us see, let us look at the 5 precepts. You all know the 5 precepts. You all observe 5 precepts on daily basis, and you all know the meanings of these precepts. Let us see what do they teach and what do they do, these 5 precepts. By observing 5 precepts, what do we learn? We observe 5 precepts. The precept number 1 is refraining from killing. We observe the precept number 1, refraining from killing. By observing that precept, what do? We respect the right of everybody, the right of everybody to live, have a free life. And we observe not to take what is not given to us, whatever which does not belong to us. If something does not belong to us, we do not have a right to take it. If we take something which is not freely given to us, we call it stealing. So, refraining stealing is another precept. By doing that, by observing that precept, we respect the right of others, the right of others to have their belongings, their things freely. So, we respect that right. And then we observe another precept, not to misbehave in the society. Misbehaving in the society is a big problem. If we breach, if we break the law, if we do not obey the law, we can't be good citizens. So, by observing the precept to behave in the society well, we become good citizens. We become law-abiding citizens, we call them. We respect the law. We do not break the law. We respect others. So, that is another precept. And we also observe the precept not to tell lies. Telling lies is a very bad quality. So, by not telling lies, we learn to speak truth. We always speak truth. Good people always speak truth. Telling lies is not accepted. If you tell lies to your parents, if you tell lies to your teachers, it is not good. So, we always learn to speak truth. We always learn to tell only the truth. So, by practicing, by following, by observing that precepts, we can be good citizens, we can be good people. And if you tell lies, people would not trust you. So, you will not be a trustworthy person if you tell lies. Whoever who tell lies is not a trustworthy person. So, when you always speak truth, people will trust you. You will be a trustworthy person. So, whatever you tell, people will believe. So, that is another precept. And finally, we observe in the 5 precepts not to use drugs and intoxicants. That is another big problem in the society, especially young people. Sometimes they are misled and they are misbehaved and by using drugs and intoxicants. So, by observing 5 precepts, by observing the 5th of these 5 precepts, we make a promise not to take drugs, not to use intoxicants, which are really, really harmful for us. They are harmful for our physical body, they are harmful for our mentality, our skills, our talents will be ruined if you use drugs and intoxicants. So, as Buddhists, by observing precept, we observe the precept not to take drugs and intoxicants, which are very harmful for our lives. So, that is only one advantage that we get as Buddhists by following Buddhism as a religion, observing precepts. So, we just only talked about the five precepts. As you know, there are 8 precepts, there are 10 precepts, sometimes we observe them, especially on observance days, poya days, full moon days, we observe these precepts. So, by observing precepts, we can be good people, we can be good citizens, and you all can be good children, and you can have a bright, successful future, and your future will be a bright one, a successful one, if you observe these precepts. Apart from precepts, there are many more things that we can learn from our religion, Buddhism. Let us see what are the things that we can enjoy in our religion. Now, as little children, I know you all like to listen to stories. You all like to listen to stories which are interesting. So, in Buddhism, there are many, many stories. You all have learned, you all are learning the story of the Buddha, which is a nice story. You all love to listen to it and love to learn to it, learn it. And there are many more things. This religion, this Buddhism, our religion has a very big literature, full of stories. We call them Jataka stories, the birth stories of the Buddha. And we are learning more stories. We are learning the stories of other bhikkhus, other monks, nuns, who lived at the Buddha's time. As I said, we have a history of 2600 years. So, this 2600 years history is full of stories, enjoyable things. Stories of the Buddha, stories of other bhikkhus, monks, nuns, little children like you. I hope you all have heard the story of Sunita and Sopaka, little two kids who lived at the Buddha's time, who were helped by the Buddha, and Buddha showed them the right way and took them from their suffering to happiness. So, like that, we can learn lots of stories when we study, when we learn Buddhism. So, that is another part of Buddhism. We can always enjoy it. You can always enjoy it. You can enjoy learning Buddhism as a religion by listening to the stories, by listening to many interesting characters, characters like you, children's stories, and many more things. That is another part of Buddhism. And as you grow on, as you grow up, as young adults, you will be learning some advanced teachings of the Buddhism. Something like karma. Karma is very well known now. It is known all over the world. You know what karma is. Karma is the actions that we perform. The actions that we perform intentionally, we call them karma. So, as you grow up, you will be learning those things. And why do we learn those things? Why do we learn those advanced topics in our religion? That also helps you. Let us take karma as an advanced teachings of the Buddha. Now, karma is the actions that we perform intentionally with our physical body, or with our words, the words that we speak, or the thoughts that we think. We call them the mental karmas. So, when we learn karma as a concept that helps you, as I said, we know how to do only the good things, only the good actions, only the good deeds, be it a physical deed, be it a mental deed, or be it a verbal deed. Now, physically, you do many deeds, many actions by using your physical body, your physical body. And we do many actions by using our words, the words that we speak. And also, even though we are not doing anything physically and verbally, we still think the thoughts in our mind. Now, when you learn a concept like karma, you can make all your physical, verbal and mental deeds good ones, because karma teaches you how to distinguish the good and bad karmas. If you do something bad with a bad intention with your physical body, your words or your mind, that are called bad karmas. Now, as a result, if you do bad karmas, you will have bad results. So, that prevents you from doing bad karmas. When you learn a concept like karma, that is the advantage that you gain by learning it to your life. And ultimately your life will be a good one when you learn such advanced teachings of the Buddhism. Now, on the top of all these things that I have been mentioning, there's very, very important thing that we all learn from our religion, Buddhism. What is that? That is meditation. We call it mindful, we call it meditation, whatever you call it. That is a very precious gem that we find in the teachings of the Buddha. I know as little kids, you are practicing meditation to some extent. Maybe you are practicing meditation for few minutes. Maybe you are practicing meditation as a way of concentrating, as a way of calmness, to make your body calm, to make your mind calm, and as a way of improving your studies. So, whatever way you use it, it is a very helpful, very advantage, very good advantage that you can gain from Buddhism. I know you all are practicing meditation, and you know the way in which meditation should be practiced, because as Buddhists, in the temples, in your Dhamma schools, you learn from monks, from your teachers, from your parents, how to practice meditation. So, if you make it a habit, if you practice meditation on daily basis or whenever and wherever you can, it will be a good advantage. It will help your studies, your concentration, and of course, I know as little children, with loads of studies, homeworks and many more things, sometimes you are stressed. Your mind gets stressful. So, to reduce your stress, you can use meditation as a practice. So, from where we learn meditation, we learn meditation from our religion, from Buddhism, because Buddha taught us how to meditate. As a young kid, Buddha, he himself used to meditate. And by meditating, he became the Buddha. And after being the Buddha, he spent his whole life teaching other people how to meditate and how to use meditation in order to reduce stress, in order to what we call eradicate suffering and to be happy. So, more you meditate, you will be more happy. And more time you spend for meditation, it will be better for your studies, it will be better for your happiness, and you can be happy, you can improve your skills, your talents, especially your concentration. Concentration is the key for your studies. If you can't concentrate on one thing, it will be very difficult for you to learn something. So, more you can concentrate, better you will be learning, better you will be understanding something. So, meditation is another precious thing that we learn by following, by practicing our religion. So, like that, there are many more things. We can enjoy our religion, we can make our lives good ones, better ones by observing precepts. We can use concepts, teachings like karma in order to make our lives better. And of course, we can use meditation as a practice in order to make our studies easier and to learn very well, and to reduce our stress, mental stress. So, like that, by learning Buddhism, we gain lots of things. By learning Buddhism as a religion, we make our whole life good ones. And ultimately, you all will be good citizens, good children, and you will be successful in your studies by achieving your goals and targets. I know you all have big targets in your life, set targets. So, in order to achieve them, you have to work very hard. When you work very hard, it can be always stressful. So, by learning Buddhism as a religion, you all can be successful children and you all can be successful citizens one day. May you all be well, happy and peaceful.